I'm glad you chose my session. So I'll try to make this a good experience as possible. So a bit about me. I'm Niraj Meegawa. I'm working as a senior software engineer for a company called ZIZ. And I'm just down from Sri Lanka, right, very close to India. Just a bit about my company. So we are headquartered in London. And we also do have another office in Sri Lanka, Colombo. And we actually opened a new office there just a few days back. We are mainly into the document management and the content management domain. So that's our forte. So coming to my topic today, Drupal, the perfect document management front end. So, a bit about what I'm going to cover today. So, I will actually provide an introduction on what I'm going to talk about and the real world problems that is there with document management, the solution that I'm proposing, and what we have developed for customized and implemented based on the solution that we are proposing. And also I'll go through two demos that will actually have different architectures all together. So how many of you use documents in your day-to-day life? Please show of hands. Okay, so as you can see by the raise of hands, also documents are really important to everyone and to companies and organizations especially. So in today's world, all companies use documents, and in the software industry it could be software specifications, could be a simple proposal, you know, whatever. Even you can handle your own documents like your movie tickets, whatever, your employment records. So it needs management. But the problem actually is, and the question to ask is, do we really manage our documents properly, right? So let me show you a few problems that companies do face in managing documents. So most companies and organizations, they have actually foreseen that they need document management and actually gone ahead and, you know, brought document management systems. But a very common complaint is that it's very expensive and the users are really not using it effectively as much, right? Why? Because sometimes you use like multiple systems to do your day-to-day work. You might have your own intranet, then you might be using a chat application like Slack for chat, and then you might be using your document management system separately. So then it's not very user efficient. The method of usage is not very user efficient. And most of these document management systems, they are very good at what they do, but what they are not good at is providing a good user-friendly experience, because most of them are fixed and, you know, people have different likings and people want things personalized, customized. So the document management system might not be very well equipped to do this. And it cannot provide like a rich user interface, like a very responsive, mobile friendly user interface. So yeah, those problems, you know, propagate into users not using this document management system effectively. And also, the most worst out of all is companies actually not realizing there is a problem and still using, you know, like good old emails to send their attachments and all these things. So how many of you send your documents in attachments? Still? Yeah. Okay, so as Bryce mentioned in Bryce's note, This is the digital revolution. We need to move on. So we need to find better and efficient ways. So you don't need to download your email attachment and months after go clicking on folders just to find that document you got on the email. Like, where is the document, right? So you don't want to do that. So that's one of the reasons that we propose this solution. So what does this solution mean? Does this mean that your document management system has to go away? No. What I'm saying is, so Drupal, in a sense, is a content management system and a very good interface. And you can build nice UI, you can make them change, you have block management, you have regions, all these things. So Drupal is very well equipped to give a good user experience. So what can we take out of Drupal and make it to good use? So what I'm proposing is, have your document management system in the back end and make the users see your documents through the Drupal interface. This is what I'm proposing in the most simplest terms, right? So what are the advantages of the solution I'm actually proposing? So one good advantage is you'll have everything in one place. So you can build your intranet, you can have a chat application, you can have your document management system integrated to it. So just one application to do everything. Not multiple applications and content distributed all over the place. And also you since Drupal is mobile friendly and it can provide a nice interface with all these HTML5 stuff coming up and all the JavaScript libraries, you can provide a nice and rich interface for the user as well. And also, we can make use of a lot of JavaScript libraries out there. So it can be like JavaScript libraries that are equipped to build graphs, and it can be annotation.js, pdf.js, all these JavaScript libraries we can make use of. And also, Drupal is a good platform to collaborate. So anyone here heard of Together.js? Yeah, so one thing you need to do is also just take down the technologies and just go and, you know, Google them out, because Together.js is a really awesome plugin. It's a Firefox, it's a product from Firefox Labs, and if there's even a Drupal module out there, but you don't really need to use the Drupal module, you can actually plug in the JavaScript library and do all the real things you want. So it's a great platform to collaborate. You can build awesome applications using that. So we get all these functionalities plus the document management side of things in one place, like document conversions, document resizing, search, all these things by using this kind of a hybrid solution. So what have we developed in order to make this solution work? So obviously you need a method of actually authentication. So how can we provide this? The way we can provide this is by communicating seamlessly through the document management system and Drupal through API calls. So another thing you should notice is most of these document management systems like Arafresco, Box, Dropbox, they have their own API, because I think that's because they also have seen this problem and posing this problem, and they provide an API for, you know, other applications to connect together. So use the API, implement a way for the applications to talk and communicate to each other without any problem. And a file browser. Also, we have developed obviously a need when we are, you know, having an interface for a document management system. File previews, where we need to, you know, preview documents. So sometimes all types of documents are not viewable on web. So what the document management is good at is actually converting the document. So if you want to view an Excel sheet, so you can tell the document management system, hey, convert this for me to PDF and get it back and show it. So this is a preview, but it actually gets the work done. And while actually developing the integration, what we also came to notice is, you know, people need to know what is happening on both the applications. So we are using a plugin. We are integrating the activity streams of the document management system and Google as well. So how we are doing this is using a protocol called Activity Streams 2.0. So it's a very simple standard of communicating activities between the application. So just a very simple standard. You should go and check it out. But it's really effective. Yeah. And another very small plugin that we also implemented is annotation of this. So what it does is it's simply annotating or commenting on a certain piece of content so that the other users also can use it. And so anyone heard of CMIS? So CMIS in long terms is Content Management Interoperability Service. It's basically a very generic API used between content and document management systems to communicate with each other. And there is an awesome Drupal module. Anyone use the Drupal module? CMIS Drupal module. So you should go and actually try and see what it is, because it's also a really good module. And it's actually a bunch of modules or a bunch of libraries. What CMIS provides is a way to communicate with other applications, and it has a browser, its own browser, where you can browse through the documents when you connect to the document management system. And it also has its client library. Then there is another module called the CMIS field, where you can use it to add the documents to a content type. So you will even find a lot of interesting contributors. So Bryce itself is a contributor for this module. So it's a very scalable module, I think, because we found out when we were developing and when we needed to make improvements that the module is already equipped to do this. So with a bit of reading and researching, we found out the module is very useful and it does a lot of work. So, and also the browser was not that flashy and not a very nice one. So we kind of changed it to this, and we wrote our own browser on top of the CMIS browser. So the solution, first solution I propose is integration between Alfresco and Drupal. So how many of you heard about Alfresco? Yeah, you're using Alfresco heavily. Okay. So Alfresco, for the folks who don't know, is a document management system and it's hugely used. So as we are a company headquartered in London, the UK government is using it, the US government is using it, and it manages terabytes of documents, right? So but what Alfresco is not really good at is providing a very rich UI, and the customizations on it are not as easy as changing Drupal. So that's the problem Alfresco is facing. But it's really good at what it does on the document management side of things. It can convert and can do awesome stuff, like permission, group, name it. It has all the fun. And a good thing about Alfresco is it provides an API for everything you see in its interface. So actually it kind of serves the purpose because of this facility it provides. So the architecture for this solution is a bit complicated, but and but you don't actually need to use this architecture. You can use a very simple ADA architecture by, you know, just configuring a user. So I'll go through it in a bit. But what basically is here is what we've done is we have Drupal in one side, and we have Alfresco, and we have an identity provider to manage the authentications, right? But in this solution, we are using identity provider called ADFS, but you can use identity providers like OpenAM, or there is Shibboleth. So we've used all those identity providers. And also we use a protocol to communicate called SAML 2.0. So it's a protocol that is used for proper authentication, managed authentication. And so just to go through the architecture very basically, what Drupal does is, so all the applications should be registered with the identity provider first, and even all the users. So there might be Active Directory or something created there. So what Drupal will do is Drupal will ask, send a SAML request to the identity provider, and the identity provider will provide a response. And this response is used to actually build that level of trust with the other applications you are talking to. And it might not be just two applications, it might be multiple applications and different Drupal instances and different Drupal Alfresco instances and all these things. So that's how it basically works. And once Drupal sends the SAML response to Alfresco, so Alfresco will then study the response and say, okay, you are good to communicate with me. And after that, it's all CMEs doing the work. So if anyone wants more details about the architecture, please come and meet me on the session. But it's a bit important when you're going to understand the demo. So that's why I came to go ahead and explain. And there is also an Alfresco module actually working on Alfresco that actually is easy implemented. So it's a bit independent, dependent on that module that you need to install. So I'll give you download links as well. But that's why I'm providing two solutions. So we'll see what happens. So this is the README file from the CMIF module. The array at the top should be placed on your settings file. Pretty much straightforward parameters that you have to provide. Just by using those things, you can make this integration work as well. But the disadvantage here is you will have to use one default user, which is not very good because you are logging into your Drupal instance with your own user credentials. But someone, the person who is doing document management in the backend is another person. So we don't want that. So we thought of making this work the proper way, which means that logged-in Drupal user should be the person who is also doing the work on the document management system. So what we actually did is we used this transport key right at the bottom. And using that transport key, you can write your own module to take care of authentication. So that's what we did. And we made sure that the SAML requests and all these things are working with that module. So that's basically what the configuration is. And the next part is in the CMIS module, you'll have to, configure a default location or a location you want the browser to see. So once you click on the CMIS browser link, this location will be shown up to you in your browser. So that's all the configurations. So let's get to the demo. Can you see this clearly? Yeah. It's just a white screen right now, but and you have to see the mouse point and not the player. I'll just bring it to a point where it starts playing. Yeah, okay. And that. You guys. So, first up, what I'll demonstrate is the single sign-on process, which is really cool in keeping the permissions independent. So you don't want to manage your permissions for the document in Drupal. That will actually create a whole mess and a long list of permissions. So you just let the document management system deal with document permissions and let Drupal actually do what it's doing there. So that's why we are proposing this kind of authentication. So the user would log in to and when he does this, he'll be logging to Drupal as well as the address code. So just to show that, I'll just open the documents tab, right? And also I'll open the same location on address code on another tab, right? So it will be the same user, Mark Austin or M. Austin for short. So when you open the same location on Artisco, you see you don't need to sign in again. You are signed in already. And it's the same thing we are mimicking on. So, let me go this back. Yeah, so what I'm doing here is I'm going to change browsers. And I'm going to remove permissions for a folder. I'm going to actually log in as an administrator to the document management system on another browser, and I'm going to remove permissions for a folder there. Okay, so what it should do is it should remove the permissions from Drupal as well as the address. Go into a folder, I'll just take the Drupal folder, go to manage permissions. And just remove all the view permissions from that folder. So save it. And when you go back and refresh, you should not see the Drupal folder anymore, right? So refresh both. So you don't see the Drupal folder anymore. So that's the importance of keeping the permissions independent. You don't have to deal with the lock. Pretty much all the authentication process. So now let's go through what modules we need to actually enable to make this solution work, right? So let's go to the modules. And you need to first enable your CMeet module. So just not all the modules here. So you need the CMeet module, the CMeet browser. The theme is common, and of course then the theme is fields. So basically the first three modules will work, make the document browser work, but if you want to connect your documents to Drupal node, you can use the theme field module, which will I will also demonstrate later on. And next, the customized module that we ourselves wrote. So the Alphasco annotation is to actually annotate the document. The tasks is actually a display of the workflows assigned to you on Alphasco. And we got our own browser written on top of the CMeet browser. We've also got a calendar plugin, which is not important actually for this demo, but you can also use that. It will integrate the events of the two applications. And also, of course, the Drupal Alphasco connector, which takes care of the authentication. Yes? Alphasco has its own role of roles and permissions, and Drupal has its own roles and permissions. But because when we thought of actually merging the permissions, that's going to be complicated. So on Alphasco, the administrator can make sure that any groups are there, and it's just a matter of the same user logging in to both the systems. And whatever the document that they can't see on Altusco cannot be viewed on Drupal as well. So that's why we are keeping it independent, so you know, it's not mixed up and complicated altogether. So but when you are going to merge it inside your application, it's going to make the actually the implementation much more difficult. So that's why we thought of keeping it this way. So to continue, I'll just go through the features. So this is just Drupal Commons working. And we've integrated the activities, as you can see. The top two are Alfresco activities, which we pulled in. So it's integrated, and the bottom ones are from Drupal itself. So what we can do, a cool thing we can do is we can also pull in the real thumbnail. So the topmost activity is actually a thumbnail that we pulled in. So that's actually a real thumbnail that we pull in from the uploaded document. So it can be uploaded from the browser itself or from Alfresco itself. But we can, you know, just pull in the activities using the integration that we built. The task integration, so it actually shows any workflow that is assigned to you on Alfresco. So this user is obviously late on all the tasks. And let's straight away go into the documents. So once you go into the documents tab, you will get the browser. So the browser has a couple of features. First of all, starting from the left side, there is just the tree view navigation, which makes it altogether easier to actually navigate. And then you have a refresh button, because sometimes the sync doesn't work instantly when you upload a document, and you've got the feature to actually upload a document, and you can create folders. So everything will be done on the current location you are in, and you can also drag and drop, because drag and drop is also a common feature that users ask for. And even small front end, this is not federated search, just a small front end filtering that we are doing. So yeah, let's take a look at the preview. So let's preview a document. So as I said, we can tell Alfresco to convert any document into whatever the format we need. So here we are using pdf.js to actually load the document. And what it will do is it will send back the document, and we can open it with pdf.js. So we will tell Alfresco to send all the documents in pdf.js just for the preview. And another small integration that we've done is make the ability to for the user to actually annotate the document. So you can just highlight just a phrase of words and just comment on it, so that any other person actually opening this document would see this annotation or see this comment. So that's pretty much the preview functions. So we've also got the functions like delete, download, and all these things. And we've also placed the breadcrumb at the top for easy navigation again. That's pretty much what we've got on the browser side of things. Now, next, let's go into actually connecting these documents from the document management system to Drupal nodes, right? So you can use the CMIS field module for this. It's just, you enable the module and you will get to add the field in your content type. So you can just add, and the third field over here is actually CMIS field. Again, what it will do is it will open a small widget for you once you press the browse button, and you can just browse through and actually choose the document you want. A cool thing here would be to actually add a search where you can search through documents and just choose. But we have not come to that stage yet, but we are just choosing the document here and just. It will if you make the Drupal site mobile enabled. So if your mobile Drupal site is actually mobile responsive, then it will work, the whole thing will work on your mobile browser as well. So that's the advantage of having. But you know, with Arafesco, they had to build a whole app for mobile browsing. So you don't need to do that with this kind of integration. You can just make your site responsive. And
my example is
okay. I'm not sure. I've not tried it on a browser, but I don't know. Should work if the mobile site is responsive. So you can just save, and you will have your document linked to your Drupal node. Right. So that's all on the first solution. And going back to my slides. So, solution two is the integration between Box and Drupal. So, this is actually personally for me, I like this because it's much more simpler than the Arafesco integration. And the architecture is also not very complicated. We just use OAuth2 protocol to communicate. So it's not dependent on anything on Box. Just dependent on the API of Box. That's it. We don't need to write any code on Box. Let's straight away get to the demo. Just 3 months back, and it's still in the sandbox stage, so you'll have to clone it or either update. So we'll just clone the module. And then also we've written our own PHP SDK to communicate with the API. And so it's actually included inside the module right now, and we have not decided whether to pull it out or just keep it inside the module, but it's currently inside the module. So you need to just go inside the SDK folder and download its dependencies. So you just need to run a Composer install. So why we've done this in this way is we also thought of Drupal 8 and we want to port this straight away into Drupal 8. Yeah, that's it. So your module is all ready to go. So now what you got to do is you just go to modules and just enable the module. So it's called Box Connector. You switch it on and you're good to go. So the configurations in the Box module are pretty straightforward. You just have four parameters to fill in. So for this, you need to have a developer or enterprise license or account on Box. But the developer license serves the purpose. So what you need to do is you just need to go into my apps on developer.box.com. right? And just create an app by just clicking this link, right? But I got my own apps created, so a kind of complicated thing with Box is they have two APIs. So one is the content API and one is the view API. So the content API actually takes care of the documents, uploading, deleting, all these things, but the view API is the one used for viewing. But I heard from Box that from just recently onwards, you don't need to use both APIs. You can use just the content API, because the content API has a new preview API call. So you can just use that preview call and just view the document. So, but at the stage of development, we had to deal with two APIs. So let's see, you just create a content API and a view API. So once you create it, you will get these keys. So what you need to do is you need to add these keys into your Drupal configuration. And once you do this, you should be able to properly communicate through the OAuth protocol using these keys. So we also need to go into the view API and just add the view API key also. So add that, and that's it. We are good to go. So once these configurations are saved, you can just go to your user page. And on the user page, you will see a small tab called Box. So just click on it. The very first time, it will ask for access. So you just need to grant access, and after that, you don't need to do that. So the application will have all the tokens needed to have the proper communication. Grant access, and that's it. So. Yeah, so this is the documents on Box that the user will see. So I'll open the same Box account on box.com, and these are the same files here as well. So we are trying to, actually we are in the course of improving the UI as well. For now, this is the view function. So as you can see, once we click on view, it takes a lot of time to actually view the document. This is because we are using two APIs, and it takes a whole cycle of API calls to actually view the document. So it takes a lot of time. So what we did here is, the first time the user does it, we cached it using the Drupal caching API, so that the second time the user is not frustrated like this. So as you can see, this is the first time it opens. So the second time it will not take so much time, because we are actually caching the responses from the API calls. So the second time it opens pretty quickly. So that's actually another example of using the best of both worlds. And we've got the upload functions, and you can create folders, rename and delete files, all these things are intact. Great use. So that's actually the second solution. Future plans we have. So Drupal 8 development is also going on. So we also started moving these modules, and some problems we are facing it with actually porting the Signage module and things. So it will take some time, but hopefully we are trying to give it out soon. And also, since the AlphaSCO integration is a bit complex, AlphaSCO 5 is equipped with OAuth 2 authentication, I heard, because I'm no AlphaSCO pro, but you know, I get a lot of help from the developers in our company. So we are trying to implement easy way of this complicated way of authentication for Crisco. And probably integrate the Drupal Workbench module for workflows. So let's say you have, let's say it's a newspaper and the writer has to go send the article to the editor and the editor has to approve it and it has to go to second. And so there is a lot of workflows when documents are involved. So yeah, what we are trying to do is we are trying to actually integrate the workbench module, which can actually implement workflows with Drupal Node, and try to see how the integration will work. And also, we are trying to integrate workflows with annotations, which means when an editor is like checking a document, he's going through a document, he sees something wrong with some content, annotates that part using a user mention, and that would automatically fire up a workflow. And also UI improvements and especially search, federated search. So federated search is also started up with a product called Sensify that is also on the company GitHub. So you can also check that out. Sensify is federated search. You can integrate multiple repositories with it. That's pretty much it. So any questions, please? For the YouTube video purposes, I'll repeat the question. So what he's asking is, he has a Drupal node and he's trying to attach a document. Once he attaches this, is it possible to actually upload it to Alfresco at the same time? Do you want to upload it to Alfresco and Drupal, or just Alfresco only?
Only Alfresco.
Okay. So yeah, that is possible. We actually did play around with this. You can actually, you know, once you're, let's say the content you're typing inside the text area on Drupal, you can, you know, just convert it to a PDF and even send it to Alfresco. So the attachment is also certainly possible. You use a hook in the middle and make sure that you call the CMS API accordingly, and you actually interfere with the file upload process, and in the middle you call the CMS API and send the document to Alfresco. So that's the, it's actually similar, but ultimately it will be a link to Alfresco on your Drupal node. Something similar to the CMS field I showed you. So something similar like that. But that the CMS field, the difference is it's already in Alfresco, but your way we can also make that work. Yes.
I have questions. Is it any of those options provides a version of the files upload, and the second question is it possible in any of the solutions to edit the actual files?
So one question is if versioning is possible. So no, we have not got it into Drupal yet, the versioning part of things. Both the solutions have versioning on the document management side, and they have APIs, but we have not still implemented it on the Drupal module, no. And editing, as far as I know, is not possible. So you'll have to download and do some changes and upload it again, which will actually upload a new version. Yeah, so One problem, so what he's asking is whether we can actually use another default user to always authenticate with the document management system and not the logged in user, right? So what, as I mentioned before on a previous slide, the problem that it brings is the person who is actually doing the uploading will be that default user. So you will have no track of who actually uploaded it. Sorry? Yeah, yeah, but it's certainly possible, and that's how the default behavior of the CMS module works. You can use an admin user who has permission to everything and just set up that user on your settings file, and then you can use that user to always upload the files, which there is no authentication involved in. But also the authentication that you saw, it's just only one time, even for Box. The next time you log into Drupal, we have the tokens already, so you don't need to grant access. So you can just... I'm sorry, I didn't get your question properly. Yeah. See all the documents from it. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you can do that. So what you'll need to do then is instead of actually authenticating that user, you'll have to authenticate the admin user through the backend. So not the user who's logging in. So different use cases can. Okay. But you can also, you know, create some group and add these users or something like that, so that that user is also doing, also can view the document. Or else you can make that document, particular document, public from the DMS and make sure it's seen to the user. There are multiple ways of actually doing it, but it's the one you prefer that matters. So, and also, each person's use case may differ. So that will also actually propagate into changing the architecture.
I have one question. So one solution, while you had portrayed your IDP server is different, just separate from the Drupal and Elasticsearch. Can't we use the same instance of Drupal as the IDP identity provider?
I've not tried this, but I think I'm not sure. I'm really not sure about this. I'll have to look into it. Sometimes it might be possible. So the Drupal, another Drupal instance is the IDP, and Drupal and Arafesco authenticates against it. Sometimes Arafesco might not allow this. I'm not sure. I'll have to ask one of the Arafesco developers actually. But I'm sure Drupal to Drupal, probably you can use another Drupal instance as IDP. Yeah. Sorry. It's not possible. Sorry. ADFS, OpenAM, and Shibboleth that we use. Yeah. OpenAM is open source. Shibboleth and ADFS both are enterprise. ADFS is actually a Windows, works on Windows. Please. Okay. So downloads and support, go to the company GitHub to download any of these modules. They are not there yet because there was a problem with my authentication, so I'll put them as soon as possible on the GitHub. The box module is on that URL, and you can always contact me or sales or any if you want to actually implement any of these solutions. And all over the place, I'm just Enmi Igama, so please drop me a line and I'll always reply back to you. So hope to hear back from you. Please keep in touch. And also, please go ahead and evaluate my session. Hope you had a good session. Thank you.